Hello. Let me just announce real quick that I'm started the stream. Hey guys, how you doing? I'm going to go ahead and stream DayZ now. Now, you may wonder, why am I streaming somebody else's game? Well, first of all, I'm a gamer first and foremost. Love playing a lot of games. DayZ happens to be one of my favorites. So, let me find a decent server and see what we get here. Also, if my chat would help me out, keep my potty mouth in check, it would be greatly appreciated. I do not pretend to be anything other than foul-mouthed at times, and it's difficult for me to break that habit, but I will do my best to keep this PG, like, 16-ish, probably. All right, let's find a decent server here. Okay, what do we got? I mostly look for servers with a lot of people on them. So let's connect to Seattle Dick Dick. By the way, I encourage stream sniping. Man, doesn't look like there's that many people on this server. Okay, that didn't work out too well. Hold on, let's find something else. Let's try maybe this one. Ah, that one looks like it's working. So, right before the stream, I sacrificed myself at the altar of zombies, mostly because I had a crappy spawn, so I'm sure I'm like everyone else in this game, which is I keep respawning until I get one I like. I'm not ashamed to admit it. Long runs aren't my favorite thing about this game. In fact, that's one of the reasons I like the mod better, because it does have vehicles, but and I can't wait till they come to standalone. I think it's going to make it change the game just radically. It's going to make it a lot more fun. Ah, crap. All right, this isn't the best spawn, but I'll make do. So, why am I playing this game? Well, first off, this is the inspiration for H1Z1. I have to hand it to the guys at Bohemia, and particularly to Dean Hall. I love this game. I think it's quite brilliant. Yes, it's got bugs. So what? To me, the fun thing about any game is, am I enjoying myself? Do I have fun with my friends? And probably number one thing for me is, can I gank someone? I don't tend to play games that where I can't, to be frank. You know what? Let me go the other way. I think I have a pretty good idea where I am. You know something I didn't know, but when that little red thing comes up, the little broken link thing, no one ever told me this. I saw it on a stream, but I guess that's a good indication there's another player in the area. It's pretty cool. I think I heard a zombie back there somewhere. I think this game is gorgeous. I think it's one of the prettiest games ever made, actually. Things I particularly like about it, I think their foliage and their, you know, their tree lines and how they simulate, you know, the world itself is just nothing short of brilliant. Excuse me a second, somebody's interrupting me. Oh, it does? Oh, okay. Hold on a second. I got to change something real quick. I got it. Okay. Oops. Okay, sorry, I had to make sure I updated it so it says I'm playing DayZ instead of H1Z1. Anyways, stuff I really like about it. I love the natural look of the tree lines in this game. I also love the terrain. I think the terrain is really good for spotting people, and it looks very natural. I'd heard that they use GIS data, but or you know, something similar to that, some kind of satellite data, which I think is pretty cool. I also feel like with Arma 3, when you know, playing Altus Life or games like that, really get a sense of being there, and that is one of the main reasons H1Z1 is actually still not on early access, because we've got to get that feeling in the world like you're in a real place. I think that's super important in any kind of game, whether you're making a game or a sim. You got to feel like you're there, and if you see stuff that looks out of place, you pick up on it quick. Oh, let me do some quick things here. Get rid of that stuff. Just for the inevitable. One interesting thing I find is that there's almost no servers that I find with where nighttime is running. I'm a personal fan of nighttime. I seem to be pretty alone in that. On our team, there's a lot of people that just don't like night, and I think a lot of people on DayZ do the same thing. They kind of tune out when it's nighttime, or they'll log out. So that's why you see a lot of, you know, daytime-only servers. I got to tell you, I honestly think that's sort of missing part of the game, but that's a very personal opinion. Let's see if there's anything in here. Alright. I keep hearing a zombie somewhere over there. Alright, I better get some food. The sounds in the game are pretty good too. Hey Smed, can you tell us why Swig was canceled? Jesus, you know what I'd really like to do is answer that question for the millionth and one time. So I'm gonna just not answer that. Go Google it. I've, like, answered that about 10 million times. Really. Not kidding. Been very honest about it. Ah, it looks like another player did what I did. Red beanies. I always feel like a... Like, it's kind of funny when I'm walking around with my red beanie on. Kind of funny, there's always a big debate about first person versus third person. I really, personally, I don't care about that. It just doesn't matter to me. Yeah, I know, you can cheat in third person view, I get it. So what? Makes the game fun. What's the big deal? Alright. I think this interface works pretty well. I like this vicinity thing. Love how they do the player, and I love the status here. I also like the fact that it doesn't display on my main... on my main screen. So I like a clean main screen, and we will be offering options that will let you do that as well, and there will be server rule sets where in hardcore where you will only see messages basically, but we probably are slightly more gamey than they are. And what I mean by that is we're going to put some of the game elements at least a little more in your face than they do here. That's just a choice we're making that's different from them. It will make it more gamey, but I think it's going to work better on the console because I think on a console it's not going to work particularly well to have a lot of... you don't want to have, you know, a ton of interface, but at the same time, console players do expect some level of that, and I think it's probably just not enough, at least for, you know, some players. It's going to be a long run. I love seeing that knife cutting into my back. That's awesome. See, yes, that's a bug, and I care exactly zero about that. I just think it's kind of cool looking. If that was the kind of thing holding us back from early access release, we most certainly would have it out by now. Hey, you know what? Let me take a shortcut. Nah, shit, that's not even going to be a shortcut. Hey, I'd love it if Rocket would come in here. I've never actually gotten to meet him. I like the guy a lot, especially the Mount Everest thing. If I was in shape and could do something like that, that would be a dream. El Rocco, let it go, dude. Game was canceled a long time ago. Let it go. Hey, Sacreal, how you doing, man? I watch you all the time, dude. All the time. Love your stuff. In fact, I was literally just watching you when you were streaming with your friends. Stream Eve. Unlikely. Not going to happen, simply because at some point, Eve, you need a little more clandestine, especially with the corp I'm in. Have we thought about quivers and bandoliers told arrows and ammo? Absolutely, we will have that kind of stuff. How did I get into game development? I started when I was 18 years old, right out of high school. I actually went to San Diego State University, but not really. I was there for 2 years, but during that 2 years, I accomplished very little because on the side, I was game programming on the Apple II Plus, and my very first game was a game called Kix that I did on contract, and I think I got paid $15,000 to port it. It was a fun job. That was, and I, you know, had taught myself 6502 assembly language by that point in time. Swig got you into PC gaming? That's awesome, man. It was a great game. Really is. I think the great thing about that was the, you know, world simulation was just amazing. Yeah, way back when I was 18. I'm 45 now, dude. 45. And I'm going to be gaming when I'm 95, I hope. I'll probably die of a heart attack long before that. If I don't start dieting a little better. Yeah, I was a programmer. Actually, I started my first company called Knight Technologies. I think I was 19 or 20 when I officially formed it, because my first contract, I just did it as a independent contractor. Do we have any plans on the Oculus Rift? Absolutely we do. In fact, I just got my personal one. I'm a registered Oculus developer myself. It's a little bit of a mess right now with the DK2. I logged on the other night with downloaded their latest, and there's still a lot of work to do. But man, oh man, when that thing works, it is amazing. So yeah, we'll be adding support for that for sure. Something I really dig about this game, it's the subtle stuff. Like when you're running, the breathing sounds and you know, the way you sound like a caller to some late night radio station sometimes when you're with the heavy breathing. Yeah, I agree, Sacriel. I don't know about you, but I can't even get most of the demos to work. So I'm just kind of waiting it out to see some decent software updates. Look, they have the best programming minds in the world on that thing. So it's going to be awesome. We all know it. Will H1Z1 release this year? Oh, yeah. H1Z1 is starting to look like DayZ. No. This is DayZ, not H1Z1. In fact, I just had to correct that. This is probably the point where I miss vehicles. Not gonna lie. Probably my least favorite part about this game. But one nice thing about it is you can drink beer while you're running. Now, auto run would not kill them. I'm not into the put the quarter in the keyboard thing. I'm not above it, but I'd prefer if there was a nice simple auto run option, and yes, we will have that. And I will be playing H1Z1 after this. Actually, quite deliberately. I want to show you guys the differences and talk about the things I think we're missing. And the stuff I think we've got some, you know, pretty nice things to show too. It's going to be stuff you've seen before. But I'll answer a lot of questions from the chat. Why did you choose the H1Z1 virus? God, that's a tough question to answer. Ooh, let me see. I better get some food. One funny thing for me is I switch between H1Z1 and DayZ a lot, so the keys are just slightly different. I think we're probably going to add some sort of a DayZ key set thing to make it an easy transition. Oh, nice backpack. Okay. I always like running around with one of these kids' backpacks on. Just looks funny to me. There better be some tricycles, huh? Well, we will have bicycles, which means we'll probably have tricycles at some point. So, yeah, bicycles are a thing for us. We're definitely putting them in. Uh-oh. I think I got one behind me. Yeah, there he is. Yeah, not a big deal. What is a favorite feature in any game that I've helped create? That's an interesting question. Because making games is a very team-oriented thing, at least the size of games that we make. So, and the reason I say that is because a lot of times the features, they're things that we as a team put in, not, you know, that I just force into the game. Although I'm not above that either, as most of the people at SOE will tell you. I think one of my favorite things was probably I was a pretty big champion of getting Twitch integrated into PlanetSide 2. I'm real excited about their API. I like it, and I think a lot more games need just one simple one-button streaming, and I think you're starting to see that. Uh-oh, that's a player. And this is when... Or is that a zombie? Hey, can you hear me?
What's going on, dude?
What's up, man? How you doing?
You have a weapon?
No, no weapon, man. Well, I got a knife.
Okay.
You're not gonna.
You, man.
You're not gonna. You're not gonna kill me or anything, are you?
Thing? No. We're not gonna kill you.
What do you mean, we? Oh, shit. Oh, hey, how you doing?
Yeah, we.
What are you guys up to?
We're just hanging out, man. Just cruising through, you know? Seeing what's going on over here.
You guys have an extra gun?
No, I don't. I'm sorry.
Oh, great. I'm being handcuffed? Dude, what do you want to do to me? I'm not into that kind of thing, man.
Oh, I'm sorry, bro. I'm just...
I'll tell you what. Go ahead. Handcuff me. Enjoy.
Okay.
If you, like, put me in your van, I'm going to be pretty upset.
We don't have a van, bro. I'm just going to put you in the forest right now.
Okay.
I'm kidding, bro. You need some food or anything?
Yeah,
you
I could use
get
some.
Away there. You can get away.
I could use some food, man.
Here, I'll drop you some food.
Thank you, brother. Now, I'm not going to lie,
there
Twitch
go,
stream.
Enjoy.
If I had any weapon, I would gank these guys on sight, but I don't. I've got this knife. And I'm not as good as Lyric is at popping dudes in the face. Plus, that guy's
got
a...
Well, we don't have handcuffs. I mean, keys. So you're going to have to wiggle out of them. Do you not do that?
I do not. How do you wiggle out of them?
You got to kneel down. Kneel down and then keep hitting A and D back and forth. And those are badly damaged cuffs, so you'll be able to get out of them.
What's the kneel down command? I forget. Not something I'm practiced in.
D.
X. There you go, and then tap A and D left and right. You'll be able to wiggle out of them. There you go. Because they're badly damaged, so you should be able to get out.
See, this is the kind of stuff that makes DayZ what it is, man. Role-playing. So much fun. Of course, right now it looks like I'm pulling something out of my ass, but that's okay. Yeah, not really wiggling out of them, guys.
You should. It's like badly damaged, so you're good. You could get away from there.
Yeah, the only ones you can't get out of are the pristine. If they're pristine, you can't get out of them. But if they're damaged, you can.
How long does it take?
And those are badly damaged. It depends. Not very long, usually. Some people get out of them right away. You just gotta keep doing it.
Obviously, I suck at getting out of handcuffs.
So are you alone here?
Yep.
Where did you spawn?
I don't know what the name of that spawn is. BFE is what I like to call it.
And you're a Bambi that spawned there?
No, dude, I'm not a bandit. I'm a good guy. Friendly all the way.
No, Bambi.
No, Bambi. He said Bambi, not bandit.
Oh, sorry, yeah. I'm definitely a Bambi. Okay, this has to be one of the stupidest looking things I've ever seen, but I love it all the same.
Get out yet?
Nah, man, it's cool though. I will. You know, I don't know about you guys, but my ass itches right now.
Don't forget your way. Just keep on hitting A and D, and don't forget your food. It's right.
Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.
Yeah, don't forget your food, man.
There.
All right.
If you get raped, just tell them don't stop.
If I get raped, tell them don't stop. More. Okay, cool. Well, I was Mike Tyson's prison cellmate for a long time, man. I'm all good with that.
Amen.
All right, that's cool.
That's awesome.
All right, bro. You all right?
Uh-oh. Something tells me I'm screwed here. This is awesome. One thing I'm not a fan of in DayZ is the really long input buffer they have. Jesus. It's like when you punch. I get to wait. My guy's still picking his ass while I'm doing this. Have we considered VR support? Yes, we have. We'll be doing Morpheus. We'll be doing Oculus. Hey, Sacreal, you have any advice here, brother? This is killing me. Can't stand up. This is awesome. This is definitely where I miss my dev commands. God damn it. No zombies. This is spectacular. Hello, zombies, are you here? That input that input buffer is still going. I'm literally not touching the keyboard. You have to lay all the way down to wiggle. I can't lay for some reason. I'm hitting Z, but it's not working. It's not registering. I think it just got a really long input buffer. Like, crazy long. Yeah, I can't. It's not registering anything. Hold on one second. Let me try something. Nah, that didn't work. This is honestly why I love DayZ. I mean, it would be cool if I could get out of this right now, I admit. But it's the interactions. It's the role-playing. That's what this is really all about. I like this game because I'm not as fast as I used to be with COD or games like that. So it's a much more tactical game, which I appreciate. Now, it doesn't look very tactical right now. Right now, it looks like a ass-scratching simulator, but, you know, eventually I'll get out of that. Hold on, let me try one other thing. No? Man, oh man, their input buffer... Okay, I'm going to have to log real quick. Let me see if that fixes this. Okay. Here we go. Much better spawn. All right. Now we're cracking. Have a blister on my butt. Yeah, I think so. A thumb-shaped blister. Oh, I didn't know that. You die if you log off with handcuffs on? That's cool. That's awesome. We definitely will be adding handcuffs and that kind of thing. We want as much role-playing stuff as we can possibly give you. I mean, I have been handcuffed once before and forced to drink something. I think it might have been bleach. I can't remember what it was. But, ooh, hold on. Nope. I get too paranoid sometimes when playing first person, huh? Yeah, not me. Honestly, I think it's my preferred playing method with this game. I go third person if I'm on a third person server sometimes, but usually I prefer first. That's just a personal preference. Yeah, handcuffs, roleplay, what are we trying to make here? Yeah, I get it. But you know what? Don't knock it till you tried it, pal. Phantom sounds. Oh, that's what those are. I never knew that was a bug, man. I actually have always been looking around for zombies when I hear them. It scares the crap out of me sometimes. Can we expect a wide variety of revolvers and... Yes. The answer is yes. Because it takes place in America, hell yes. Actually, it doesn't really matter. We want to put a ton of different kinds of guns in. Yes, we'll get a decent variety of shotguns. Confirm. Smed suggests kinky handcuff fun. That's not quite what I suggested. What I suggested was that it is an enjoyable role-playing element at times. If you do not get off on being handcuffed in a video game, I understand that. For me, it's just fun. I would much rather be putting somebody else into handcuffs, have them standing before me, and then shoot them in the back of the head anyways. But, hey, that's just how I roll. Ooh, bus. Yeah, there's rarely anything decent on them, but every now and again. I think there's some water back there, too. Locked. Screw it. Let me get down here and get some water real quick. I think there's a swamp up here you can drink from. I can't remember. Seawater. EV827, honestly, be honest here. Didn't you have an awesome time doing that? Honestly. I think getting handcuffed and forcing you to drink disinfectant and dying slowly and miserably, that's fun, isn't it to you? What are you most excited about the Oculus? The immersiveness is amazing, and I think it takes the right kind of game, and I think H1Z1 is a perfect example of the kind of game that will work well with it. Same with this game, actually. Why am I promoting a rival game? I'm not really promoting it, per se. I'm playing it. I would promote it. I think it's a hell of a game. Why shouldn't I? This is not a zero-sum game. I absolutely believe they can be successful and we can be successful, and that's just how I view the world, though. I don't like to talk crap about other people's games. Not my thing. There's 100 things that I can find wrong with this game, but none of them obscure my enjoyment of it to a great degree, so why should I? Would the Oculus Rift work with SOE mode? Wow, that's a great question. Yeah, I have to give some thought to that. Probably it would. What kind of game would I love to make in the future at SOE? Well, before we were making H1Z1, we were making a World War II round-based MOBA FPS. Very unique game. So think planet-side scale, but slightly smaller, maybe 500 with 250 on a team, and MOBA-like elements. And what I mean by MOBA-like elements, not the view or anything like that. What I'm talking about is the idea of the hero's journey from 1 to 25, and that everybody starts the game out, you know, basic, and you sort of gain power as you play the game. So we were making that game before we were making H1Z1. We put it on hold. It is not canceled. It's only on hold because we're waiting for some tech to be delivered before we can do it justice. So we're pretty stoked about that. Why has there never been a Wild West MMO? I don't know, man. It's funny. I love watching Westerns, but Red Dead Revolver, that kind of stuff. There's a few games out there that are decent, but I suspect it's just because it's not a genre enough people want yet. Maybe there will be one. At SOE, we kind of make the games we want to make and stuff we're passionate about. It was funny, when we switched from Sturmandrang to H1Z1, it was just an instant thing where everybody felt like it was the right thing to do. Will we ever see a sci-fi MMO from SOE? Oh yeah. We could be making one now. There we are, there's a police station. By the way, I would just point out that PlanetSide 2 is kind of sci-fi, but at the same time, it's also not an RPG either, so. All right, let's see if we get anything here. Probably not. Door's already open. Nada and nada. Okay. We'll look upstairs, but there's probably not going to be anything. Oh, awesome. I can get some running shoes and some kvass. Not gonna do that. God, the frame rate is just ass right now, and I apologize for that. I actually run a triple Sly rig here, but we have a bug in it with H1Z1 that we need to get fixed. And until then, the interface isn't showing up, so I've disabled my Sly. We just stop in here real quick, see if there's any food. Nah. By the way, Sacriel, I fully invite you to come on and stream snipe me. More than welcome. In fact, anybody, I don't care. Better find some food here. Every time I watch Sacrail or somebody else play, they always are these fully geared up men, and I feel like a absolute wuss with my Bambi outfit on here. Yes, I clicked archive stream. I did do that. Oh, Sacriel, I don't consider it stream sniping if I invite you to. H1Z1 looks better than DayZ. This is a gorgeous game. We have a completely different art style, so I don't know, man. I admit you do have to have some high specs to get the kind of look that really makes this game awesome, but I don't know, man. This is a beautiful game. Absolutely gorgeous. I didn't say we're working on a sci-fi MMO. The map has been around for ages. Yeah, That's true. That is something actually that's going to be pretty cool about H1Z1 is that we're going to be rapidly expanding the map. In fact, the technology that we're working on right now is precisely to allow that. We will have whatever 128 times 128 is in terms of total size in kilometers for our final map. It's going to be quite large. Our goal is to kind of make a microcosm of the entire U.S. I love the map here. Probably my single biggest complaint about DayZ's map is a very simple and maybe a dumb one for most people. But I don't like that I can't read the damn signs. So I've gotten to know the cities, but that's like, that. I shouldn't have to. I just want to be able to read. I actually feel like I'm in Iceland or something. I don't know how many of you have ever been there, but you go there and you can't read a damn sign. It's like 25 consonants with two vowels in it is the name of a street. Smed, aren't you afraid the Forge Light engine is not optimized and needs work? You know, I gotta tell you, the optimizations that we have underway right now are pretty substantial. And in H1Z1, actually, we built some very serious optimizations in day one because we have some things that are different between what PlanetSide 2 does and what we're trying to do with H1Z1. So, apples and oranges. But I can respect the question because, you know, our stuff isn't always as optimized as it needs to be. What is your honest opinion about Star Citizen? Well, I'm a fan of the idea, and I'm just going to wait a little bit more because until it's more of a full-blown game. Right now, my honest opinion is I like Elite Dangerous. Jimmy's in chat answering a lot of the questions, so please fire them off, guys. And, you know, later on I'm going to be streaming the latest build of H1Z1, assuming it has doors opening. But I do want to kind of compare and contrast some stuff here. My intent is certainly not to show where we're better. It's just more like where we're different. And so you can actually get, you know, first this, then H1Z1, and you can see the differences for yourself. Some of the stuff that I think they've got that we need... you really, really feel like you're in a place. And when I like going down into this area here, it feels like a little tiny downtown area of a village. I like that. That's what we're working on. We don't want to put it out there with just a bunch of remote buildings. We're trying to make it a real place. So, and that's going very well. We've got a great downtown areas, two cities being built, more like towns, I should say. And it's coming great. Ultimately, we will have full-blown cities. That is where we're headed. That is precisely why we need the new engine. And the odds of anything being found here are probably slim and none, but I will find some people here, no doubt. Oops. Duh. That was stupid. Ruh-roh. Goddamn zombie. Hold on, let me get her to chase me and... What's up? She hasn't noticed me yet. There we go. When stuff doesn't notice you, that's usually a sign that the server frame rates are low. I think I saw Rocket mentioning that that was something they're working on heavily. That's the same in our game. It's the same in virtually any online game. When stuff doesn't respond quickly. See how it goes to where my position was? That's a sign of server lag. I'm not trying to show their badness. We have the same thing at times. Magic. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
What's going on?
Hey, who are you?
We're actually watching your stream right now. What's going on?
What's up, man? If you want to drag, if you want to pop that zombie, that'd be great. I'm trying to get in there and see if there's any guns.
I'll pop it right.
Thanks, dude. Many thanks. I didn't think I'd find anything here. God damn it. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, this frame rate is killing me. Oh, hello.
I'm gonna escort you around.
Oh, thanks. I don't feel like heading to an airfield, too long of a run. Oh, there is a God.
Hey, man.
Hey.
Nobody right here.
Whoa.
Watch out behind me.
What'd you say?
Dude, come here, right on the ground.
Ah, thank you. No, I'm good.
Are you shooting?
No, I'm looking for the magazine, actually. Where'd I put the magazine? Damn it.
Here, I got another one.
I think it's that bug where they go under the ground or something.
It's right here, right in front of you. Was there one in it? If you hand it back, I'll load.
I don't know if I have space for it in my inventory. I don't know why it's... Hold on.
Do you have your post-processing to, like, maximum? Because if you do, it bugs out.
Yeah, I do, actually.
That's fun. Good. If you catch me, I swear to Jesus, I will actually dome.
No, dude, that would be wrong. I'm not gonna lie, normally I would. Totally.
I can't believe, like, what? Creator? Sony president. Oh, here, ammo. Forgot.
Yeah, so this restarts in 10 minutes, so you need...
Thank you.
I haven't played this character in like...
I just want you to understand the amount of self-discipline it takes somebody with my PK nature not to click the button.
I know.
But I'm going to be a good guy.
I wouldn't be too rattled. It's actually fun creating a new character in this.
Yeah, I agree.
It gets boring. Like, what I am right now, like, I get bored playing this.
Where do you guys want to go?
Do you need any water?
Oh yeah, I could use water and food, dude.
I'll give you some, I don't know, this cereal kind of dehydrates you, but you got that water there.
Actually, not sure.
Oh, shit. You just fell to the ground. I thought you died. Oh, my God.
No idea why that happened. Welcome to DayZ.
Okay, we need to move out of this area. They're just going to spawn on here. Yeah, let's move. Let's go. You need to find some gear.
Yeah, I know. I didn't intend to stream for so long that I was going to run to the airfields.
Oh, okay. I'm just curious. When you stream in H1Z1?
Oh, it'll be right after this. I'm not going to be playing too much longer. What I really wanted to do was kind of show the direct differences between the games because, and just explain it a lot more.
Okay. See, not everyone's an asshole.
In DayZ, no, most people are assholes. That's the best part about it.
Yeah, but it is. So sometimes being nice is fun.
Oh, yeah. I mean, sometimes I hang out with dudes and just I'll play for 3 or 4 hours with a group. That's fun, but it's also fun just to gank some fully geared guy.
Oh, time out. I just saw it on your stream. These guys are saying we have hacked ammo. No,
we
have the, I have not died on
this
character in a long time.
I don't
and have
60
rounds. Fuck
hacked ammo. Yeah, we still have the, we can show people here. I'll lay them on the ground.
Actually, that is one thing I do want to point out. We have very, very good security with our games, and I think people will be happy. You're not going to see hacks on our games.
Glad about that one.
We have the 60 round clip still, because our character's been alive since like the first batch. Magazine, sorry.
That's alright, I'm out of ammo, but that's alright.
What do you need, 9 mil?
Oh, he's bleeding like shit!
Yeah, I don't have my...
Listen.
I don't have my, bandages.
Boy.
Right here, I can give you some, 9 mil ammo and equip.
Can't believe it, that. Where's all the
drop
snipers?
The
with the
you.
Fucking hunter scope. Yo, he's bleeding. Drag's behind you.
Yeah, thank you. One thing I'm not a fan of in this game is inventory management.
Oh god, it's horrible.
It's rough.
Hold up, guard me, I'm fucking... Guard me, then.
This drives me nuts. Any of you guys have an extra backpack?
Still, are you still bleeding?
Yeah, hold on.
I have a burlap sack. If you can find sticks, you can craft one. There we go.
I didn't even know you could craft a backpack. Thank you.
And then if you add a rope and sticks into that, it makes it a bit larger.
Improvise. Alright, where are the houses that spawn shit? Behind the backpack. Behind you.
This is what I love about DayZ. The funny stuff you can do.
Oh, if I were got shot in the face. Collapse act his head. How haven't we been shot? Are you? No, I mean like anyone else watching this. They could be up there hiding in the grass. Oh yeah, let's get out of here.
Oh, I'm just about to start the H1Z1 part of this. Thank you guys, I really appreciate it. What I'm going to do now is switch over to H1Z1 and see some of the differences between these games. Well, this is going to take a few seconds here while I set this up. Not sure I'm... Oh, this is awesome. I love it when this happens. Sometimes it doesn't close gracefully. Neither does our game, to be honest. Okay, 1 second. First, I need to take a quick look and see if the new build is up yet. And I am okay. Hold on 1 second. Sorry, this is going to take me a second. I'm just reading through my emails, waiting to see if the new build is up yet. And it looks like it is, so let me grab it. I'm actually going to grab a dev build, which is something you guys may not have seen before. Hold on. Bear with me here, folks. All right, I'm grabbing the latest build. Of course, when I grab the latest build, lots of times that is it's like a box of chocolates, man. You never know what you're going to get. was H1Z1 the game that was supposed to be bring Swig players back? Yeah, you know, that was probably one of the dumber things I've said. What I was referring to was kind of the crafting and the homesteading and player bases. That's really what we want the game to be about. But and so that was specifically what I was referring to. But there's also a few trolls out there that don't let me forget that I said that, so hopefully you're not one of those. Arklager is over there sweating. He shouldn't be sweating. Doors should work in this build. All right. Yay! 5 cents. Okay. And those of you that are Jim Florentine fans may know that reference. Okay. Here we go. I got no clue what's going to happen when this thing launches. So you are going to see what I see, which means it may be quite busted. We'll see. Let me quickly tweet out that I'm streaming H1Z1 again. Okay. Change something real quick. And we're off. This is our a little weather slider here thing here. Let me All right. So right away you can kind of see the graphical style is pretty different than it is with DayZ. We're going for a little more vibrant color scheme than they are. That's just sort of a personal preference with our team. We want it to be kind of a more colorful world. Oh, shoot. Okay. All right. Let me just take care of this trash. Come here, buddy. Hey! How you like that? You want some more? You want some more? Huh? You talking to me? All right. See, now the problem is one zombie, no big deal, right? Oh, now there's two. And this is when you're screwed in DayZ, or in H1Z1, because this stuff can happen pretty quick. So, luckily, there's a third. I think I better get the hell out of here. See that in the lower right-hand corner? It says H1Z1 Stage 1. Well, one of the things about this game is that you're going to have to manage disease if you actually get... if you get hit by a zombie, your H1Z1 level can increase and you can literally turn into a zombie. It's pretty cool. All right. Now, see, one of the things about this game, if you'll notice, is the way we handle zombies in this game, we want people to feel threatened by them at all times, but also feel like one-on-one that they're not that big a deal to take care of. And I'm going to die. Now, there's a combo system in this game, and if you time your punches right, you'll see multiple punches, and you'll see super punches and uppercuts, that kind of stuff. It's pretty fun. Okay. And I come outside and it's snowing. Why? Because the way our server works is it sends those messages down and we haven't hooked it up yet so that you can change it permanently. But we will. Let's see if doors are working. Ah! Yay! I feel like we have a pretty decent build here then. I have a black beanie. Let's see what's in that. By the way, when you see stuff like... Oh, God, yes. Oh. Yes. I'll put this in my The Rock fanny pack. I think that's what we should call them. Have you guys all seen that picture? It's awesome. What I want to see is the picture where people actually end up calling the rock out on it to his face, because I'd kind of like to see that. Oh, charcoal. Yeah, that can help you with fires and stuff, but I'm not really that interested in it. All right. Now, we don't have a lot of the messages coming for your drinking and stuff like that, but that stuff's coming in. All right, let's see here. Same basic idea, though. So in this game, you can do this two ways. You can be a scavenger like me, or you can be a crafter like a lot of the guys on the team. Crafting is not my bag. I just don't like it. It's never been my thing. However, I have to call out that I think our crafting system is amazing. I really do. The Paul Carrico, who's done a lot of it, really outdid himself. Real happy with it. I'll pick up a salt. Blue and orange t-shirt. All right. Not a big fan of this. Ah. Not everything is working as intended. As you can see here. You guys wonder why we're not at EA yet? This is why. Because that's not working right. Uh-oh. Holy crap. One cool thing about our zombies is that they respect doors. They don't just go through stuff. And that's cool. But we're also going to make it so they can break doors down. It just takes a little while. We want to give you some rest in between, you know, kind of zombie stuff. Let me change the weather again. And this slider isn't working right now. Hold on. Ah! Alright. Guess you guys are going to enjoy snow. It's a couple of bugs in the game right now with the weather system, and it snows a lot. It gets old. That's okay. What are we looking at for server size? Okay, here's the scoop on server size. We don't know the answer to that. Our system can handle, very easily handle, thousands of players at one time without a problem. However, we probably do not intend to have thousands when we initially launch, simply because it's probably not going to be a lot of fun to be in the zombie apocalypse when it looks like Disneyland because there's so many people around. So here's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be at probably sometime during our early access, we're going to start with a low number and gradually raise it until we feel like the density is right. It's not a technical thing, it's purely gameplay. Then as we add more world space, then you're going to be seeing the all of the awesome awesomeness that we can bring, which is a large world with a lot of people. So at the start, the world is 8K or 64 square kilometers, and as we start adding to that, we'll add density. So, you know, the density could be 1,000 on a server, it could be 500. We just plain don't know until we get a lot of people in here. And I think the most we've ever had is about 100 so far, just because, you know, company-wise, when we get big company playtests in, we could get 300 or 400 if we want. But I could tell you right now that the server needs more work before it can handle that. So, very similar to DayZ, we have a world where it's designed for you to go search around and scavenge, but the real goal here, that's empty, the real goal here is ultimately to have player housing. We want players to either barricade themselves in to an existing structure, which is going to be a big part of our game, or build their own if you're into crafting. Now, like I said, I'm not really into crafting myself, so I would probably take the route of actually barricading myself in. Maybe make an apartment my own. Maybe I'll spend the time to craft a door with a lock on it so that I can, you know, kind of make an apartment my own if I wanted to. An existing apartment. That's something that we definitely want to do. We'll also be having locks on things, so you will be able to lock stuff that is out there that you want to protect. But there will be timers, and very similar to Eve, where you have kind of timers. Oh God, there's a bear. Okay, right now, something you don't want to mess with in our game is bears. Hey, boo boo, come here. A lot of you are gonna say, "Why is that bear's feet in the ground?" And I'm gonna say, "Oh, quiet. Okay, I was just kidding, bear. Just kidding. You're not Yogi. You're a big bad bear. You're not Channel Ben." Most of you guys don't even know what the hell Channel Ben is. That's sad. Actually, it's not sad. It was a shitty TV show. Okay. I'm afraid. Yep. Oh, crap. All right. I'm going to die. I may as well man up. I'm going to punch you in the... Yep. You really don't want to mess with bears. And he killed a zombie, too. That's a great example of something we call the circle of death. In our game, one of our goals is to simulate wildlife and make it so that there's a true simulation going on at all times of the entire ecosystem. So, you know, wolves will chase rabbits, you know, zombies will chase wolves. You'll see this circle of death all throughout our game. Stuff chases each other. It's not all out to get you. They're out, they have their own wants and needs, and they need food just like I do. Let me go to a town. I'm going to cheat and just move over there. All right, so now we're in one of our towns. This is coming together. It's being worked on by a couple of our level designers. And, I mean, this is literally, if you would have seen this a week ago, it's already made huge strides. Got the clock tower in there. A lot of these buildings are furnished too already, so I'm pretty happy with that. What the way they work it is, and a lot of you have probably watched this stream with Adam or Jimmy when they're making this stuff, but what they do is an individual person will both create the building and prop it out. So our goal here is to, as we put in a building, it's basically done. Now some of the stuff you're seeing in here isn't yet propped out. That's only because the guys are still working on the building itself. Or they're working on another one. And this door is not working, but I do not think that is on purpose. What are you gonna do? You gonna come at me, man? Come on. I don't know if you guys saw that, but I'll do this a little bit more. You see the action bar at the bottom there? Our goal is to kind of not put that in your face, but keep it there enough to get it to where you can actually see what you're doing pretty easily, and we will make it so that if you want to leave it up at all times, you will be able to. If you're wondering what I'm doing here, I'm trying to lose those zombies, but now I've clearly gained more. Some people wanted to see airdrops. Let me do one. A lot of questions about airdrops. Let me explain how we plan on making it work. The idea of airdrops is not to give you items. That is not what this is about. What airdrops are for is you can think of them as buying an event. In Dota 2, you can buy a bountiful buff thing that makes it so that everybody on the server gets a prize, or six people on the server, or eight people, or whatever number you buy, and it's done randomly. Our goal is something similar. It's to provoke conflict. So When an airdrop comes in, you'll hear it. The entire server will hear it. The entire area that it's in will hear it. And that's why you don't hear it yet, because the plane's still pretty far off. This is a pretty big world. But when you hear it, the airdrop will be done into your local area, but it's a huge radius, and the entire server can hear it. I can hear the plane. I don't know where it's coming from yet. It's kind of off in the distance right now. All right, it's coming over here somewhere. There it is. Now see, watch. You'll see it drop a parachute. Sometimes it'll be close to where you were, but mostly it's not going to be. It must have dropped up. Oh, there it is. Okay. So I wait for that to drop. Now when it drops, it starts to sprout green smoke, and that is something that kind of tells you there's a visibility bug. Yeah, we're not ready for EA yet. But you'll notice that thing's pretty high, and that's by design. It takes a long time to fall to the ground because we want players to do that. You won't necessarily know what's going to be in an airdrop. In fact, one of the surprises we intend is dropping zombies. So sometimes it might be guns, sometimes it could be stuff, but it's not something you can pick necessarily. And so we want conflict. I think there's some kind of visibility bug going on right now. Stuff is popping in and out. All right. Uh-oh. Now see, this is a great example. That airdrop could actually end up on the roof of that building. Something we probably need to check for, actually, to make sure there's a solid place for it to land. And we might be doing that already, for all I know. We probably are. Or we're not. It could be one of those. Yeah, I think that went well. Now, see, there's another player. Obviously, Jimmy or Adam or somebody on the team, so let me go pop him. Now, see, you guys saw him. He's around here somewhere. I would say friendly to these guys, but they know me better than that. Oh. Uh-oh, there's two people. Pretty funny. Who is that? Now see, these guys were going for the same thing I was. And it's obviously on top of that building, so it's not going to happen. Yeah, it's on the roof. All right. You want to see two grown men fight in a game? Here we go. Oh! Wait a minute. He's gonna kill me. I can't remember if slash kill still works, but I'm not above it. This is an excellent example of what happens. Zombies hear stuff going on. That's something that's really important about our game, is that the zombies have senses. They can hear, they can see. Their hearing is quite good, so they will come from distances. And they also are drawn... Oops, yeah, you see the green smoke? That's right from the airdrop. Let me... Oh, crap. Uh-oh. This is a cluster. Not what I intended to do. Whoa. Gonna have to run. Like a little girl. Okay, I ordered another one. Let's hope it doesn't land on the top of a building next time. Now see, this is pretty funny right here. You can kind of see the speed they're going at, right? The ones that are closest will run. The ones that aren't kind of shamble and walk. Crap. Again, the line of sight is probably your best bet. Now, if you crouch in our game, you don't make noise, or at least the same level of noise. So it's pretty easy to sneak up on zombies when you're crouched in this game. Pretty fun. Ruh-roh. Here we go. Oh, crap. I don't have any decent weapon, and this many zombies I cannot take with my fists. This is kind of a prime example of what, of how our game is different from DayZ. We are pretty zombie-centric. Whoa. Now see, they have their aggro on him except for this dude right here. Now the funny thing about zombies is they share intelligence just a little bit, so they can make noise to bring other players in. Uh-oh, what's that? Oh, crap. Thank you, Jimmy, or whoever dropped that. Okay, uh-oh. Shit. That's working out really well, I think. Something that we're working on right now is the grappling system. Here, watch this. Check this out. You can push zombies off you. It's pretty fun. But actual grappling is just about to go in. And it's full on. They'll grab onto you, and when they grab onto you, they're hard to get rid of. They can be quite deadly. I'll go back to the town in a second. Oh, look, deer! Hey. God damn, that's a lot of deer. All right, this time around, somebody was criticizing me for punching deer next time, and, you know, or last time, so I'm going to do it again. Just because I thought that guy was a douche. So, hold on. Come here, deer. Yeah, I know, nobody wants to see me punching deer, but you know what? It's my stream. Alright, let's see what we can find in here. It's nice to see doors working mostly. I think some of them aren't, don't have their triggers on set properly. We also have a bug right now, which is kind of fun, which doesn't let me through some narrow doorways. One of the pieces of feedback we took from SOE Live was your feedback about doorways, and I'm kind of screwed right now. Yep. And this is why we are not in early access yet. You want to see me punch the deer. All right, well, I'll find some deer, and I'll do that. No problem. I'm not going to do any crafting. That's for the other guys to do. Honestly, like I said, not going to lie, it's not my thing. Not because I don't think it's awesome. It's awesomely done. It's just not how I play. All right, let's see what we got here. Anything? Nothing good here. Let me check this fridge. Nope. I just love that we have a fanny pack, man. Nothing beats that. That's something you don't see in DayZ. I think fanny packs are officially confirmed. All right, I'm going to hide out here for just a second and answer a few questions from chat. Will there be gas in the gas station? Eventually, yes, some of them. And we will make it so you can siphon gas. Main difference between DayZ and H1Z1 is foliage. No, not at all. Although I do think theirs is better, but we're working on ours quite heavily. And let me see. Will there be full-blown cities? Yes, just not at early access. That's probably a year away, guys. It's going to take us a while. I mean, we're getting our new engine put into this thing. We got a bunch of other stuff. Will you be able to see what equipment they have on them? Absolutely. We have attach points on things, so you can see what equipment they have, at least the stuff that's outside the backpack. Is it true that you can have nearly limitless map size with some technology that you announced a while back? I don't want to say it's nearly limitless. It's exactly 128 kilometers by 128 kilometers, whatever that works out to in square miles. Or kilometers, I mean. Could we possibly see dead players that did not sustain head damage? Yes, you can. You will be able to see people reanimate into zombies. The Rock did not say no fanny packs, dude. He has a. There's a picture of him. There's no way, man. He's got to own that. EA in a year? Oh no, God. You're talking not that long. Not long at all. It'll be before the end of the year for sure. Probably a lot before that. Could the community get a list of things to accomplish till you release EA? You know, we've debated releasing that. The reason that we haven't is that that list could change, and I don't want to be in the business of, we added this. Could there be a chance of releasing H1Z1 next month? Yes, there's a chance. How can you stop buildings from disappearing? Very simple. It's a bug. We'll fix it. I agree with you. Fanny packs make it better than DayZ. I could not agree more. On the beta, YouTubers English, what happens to the Spanish? Well, we will be doing localized versions. We'll add all kinds of different languages. Probably not at EA. It'll be English only at EA, but very shortly thereafter, we will be localizing into all the languages you would expect. You know, German, French, Spanish, as many as we can. When H1Z1 goes early access, will you have a roadmap like PS2's? Absolutely. In fact, that is one of the items on our list, is a roadmap for you guys. Will fleshlights be craftable? I don't know what a fleshlight is, and that's the story I'm sticking to. Underground bunkers or tunnels? Yes. Can you leave the airdrops on roofs and just add ladders? Yes. Ladders are not in yet. That's a pretty big deal to me. Can you explain the grappling system a little better? I'm going to save that for a later stream, because what we're going to try to do is actually get you guys a stream dedicated to that where we explain it in detail. This tech has nothing to do with EQN. They use completely different terrain tech. Completely different. Can players exploit Gamma to see at night? Negative. How are the initial spawns going to work? Well, we've got a system of spawns that does a pretty good job right now of getting you into a place where there aren't any people. The problem is there aren't enough spawn points yet, so if we get 100 people in, all of a sudden you start seeing players when you initially spawn, which we do not want. We don't want players to see each other from minute one. Do you think... I see a question about the height of the map. You know, I don't know the exact answer to that, but it's high enough that if we want to add planes, we can. What's the max zombie population? There's no actual max. It's just basically it affects server frame rate. So, you know, I've seen, you know, 100 zombies on screen, and actually my frame rate wasn't too terrible. So, but there's two sides to zombies. There's a server side, and they have to do their collision checks. They have to do their AI, and that goes on at the same time all the simulation is going on. So it all hits the server frame rate. Have you added the feature to spawn in a desired spot? No, but there will be something along those lines. That's a system we want to implement properly. We do want to let people actually be able to spawn with their friends, but we also have to kind of not make that an OP kind of a thing, because it would be really easy to do that. Is there going to be leaning and head turning? Yes, there already is. If someone builds a base, will they be able to, say, craft a sleeping bag or something that they can build a base and spawn there if killed? Yes, that is a goal. Maybe not for EA. Maybe, though. Could you show nighttime a little? All right, I will show you nighttime. Oops. Actually, what I just showed you was crash. Hold on. Uno momento. Por favor. This is, again, why you don't have EA. There are lots of crash bugs. Can you swim and get boats and rafts? Eventually, not at launch. Water's not going to lie to you. Water's not the best part of the game right now. Hold on. Here is 1 a.m. So, I earlier was talking about night in the earlier stream. This is what night looks like now. I will be honest and say I'm not a fan. There have been massive debates on the team, and they are just tooth and nail fights about nighttime. I am of the opinion that night should be dark and terror-filled. This, to me, feels like, weak daylight. A lot of times people get in the game, they don't even realize it's nighttime because it looks so bright. So I have mixed feelings on that. I will tell you, we're playing with it, and we'll probably get it to the point where we all sort of hate it and sort of like it, and that probably is the right point, and then that's when we'll be happy with it. Because right now, this is too light for me. I don't need a flashlight, and that bothers me. I mean, I need a flashlight if I want to go into buildings and see stuff, I guess. But outside, it kind of bugs me that a zombie can't sneak up on me. So that's my issue with this. A lot of the team members are hearing this now, and they've heard this from me before. So I'd prefer a much darker night than this. But I will admit I'm one of the minority on the team on that front. So, and not everything goes my way. Now, see, indoors, I love it. This feels just right to me, where you're able to have to look for stuff, and that's cool. I like that. It's just outdoors that I got the problem with it. And would we go in the EA if this was the last thing holding us back? Of course we would. Oh, hold on. I need to find another safe place because I want to I want to answer a bunch of questions. Strongly suspect zombies are going to find me in here, but we'll see. All right, let me answer some more questions. Will there be moon phases? Yes. Not at EA. In fact, right now the moon does this weird ellipse thing that we need to get fixed. Whoa. Actually, I agree with you about Planetside 2 night being too bright. I lost that battle too. I'm just a believer that nighttime should be nighttime. I'm a big fan of Battlefield 2. The Special Forces mod had some of the best nighttime gameplay I've ever seen. We want to do night vision tech, and actually it's real easy for us to do that. Uh-oh. See, this is what I was talking about. You can get kind of screwed in our game because you can get cornered pretty quick. That's what I think it should be too. Crap. Sorry, guys. Crashed again. This is what I'm talking about. I love hearing the wolves. Now, see, there's a bear. Let's see how the AI is working right now. See? Something's still a little broke because that zombie should be getting torn apart by that bear. But I think the bear's focus is a little too much forward right now. But notice the zombie going after the bear. Zombies don't care, man. They don't give an F. Hey, I'm doing pretty good on the cussing. I've only cussed a few times. I'm going to turn it back up so you guys can see a little better. This is one of the cool new things that just went in. One of the mechanic shops, kind of like that. Our goal is to put stuff in here. You're not just going to have to find fuel. Eventually, you're actually going to have to find parts for your cars. We don't intend to make transportation easy. It's definitely not our intent. Our intent is to make it hard. If you see a dude in a car, that's a man. He is somebody that has had to do a lot of work to get that. We also want to make them group vehicles. Oh, there's some guys up here. Let me see what's going on. Awesome. Let me help kill the zombie. Here. Does this help you? Does this help you? Does that help you? Oh, I didn't mean to hit him. I meant to hit whoever that is. Come here, man. Don't be a coward. Fight like a man. Oh, no, I'm really trying to hit the zombie, not you, I promise. Probably, as far as you know. Uh-oh. Okay, that's not going to work. I'm going to die. All right, let me answer some questions. I have a question. Can you barricade houses and make them bases? Yes, you can actually do that right this second. Smedley, will we get first person in vehicles? Yes, probably not at EA. Part of the problem with polling players is in something about something like nighttime is because their opinions are sort of formed already by the night we have. So when we make changes, making changes to MMOs, you know, it's an act of God because so many people are, you know, used to the way a game works and they get all pissed off. But that's why I want to make sure we get it right to begin with here. Now, see, I found scrap metal in this car. Right now, by the way, anything can go in any slot. That's something else that's going to change. It's kind of stupid that a weapon repair kit can go into the pocket of your shirt. But we'll get that. Little stuff. There's that bear again. Let me piss him off. Because that'll go well. EQ1 nighttime. Yes, 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 yes. That is what I'm talking about. That is night done right. You were scared in EverQuest 1 at night. I think this bear's AI may have been weakened a little bit. Oh, I'm wrong. I'm wrong. Oh, shit. That worked out well. Okay. When will the game come out? When we release it. There you go. So, are you going to update the graphics from the 1990 graphics you currently have? Well, I'm sorry that you do not like these. You are seeing it on a stream. If you don't like the graphics, well, this is a graphical style we're going for, man. Don't know what to tell you. Maybe the game's not for you. I don't think people are going to stick with one server for a long time in this game. There's a laundry list of them, like in Rust. You know, we do have one fundamental difference to DayZ on that front. Every character is tied to a server. So you might have a PvP character. You might have a... There are going to be some servers that probably only have PvE, much to my chagrin. And so you may want to play on that one where it's all co-op server. To me, that's boring as hell. What's the point of it? But to each his own, right? Captain K.O. Field of... Okay, Q1. Sorry. Will you be able to build your own sheds, houses, and tents? Yes, we've shown that off quite a bit. I'm not going to show it here because that would require me to craft. And there we go again. And I think I just figured out how to reproduce that bug. So, team, when you... Well, I'll tell them privately. I think I just figured out what was causing that. So I will endeavor to avoid it. See, this is nighttime right now, because I've only reset the time locally on my client. I could set it on the server, but that does it for everybody, so I don't want to do that. Something we're working on a lot more right now is trees and foliage. We don't have enough of either one. We're working on that, and we'll get it awesome. Will you be able to have some kind of boss mobs that you need to team up to fight? Yes. Yes, we will. That's another differentiator. But they'll be a little different than... I mean, they're going to be natural creatures or whatever they are, but our intent is to make some stuff just very tough to bring down. Whoa, hold on. I don't know why I'm not... It's not being captured anymore. Oh, hold on one second, guys. Sorry. Don't know why that happened. Hold on. I'm actually playing. It just isn't showing up in my stream here. Hold on. Yeah, I saw. That's odd. Sorry, guys. For some reason, it's not coming back up into OBS. I don't know why. It's probably some bug in OBS, is my guess. Hold on. I need to... probably restart it. Let me stop streaming and start it again. Hold on one second, guys. I apologize for that. Hopefully you guys can hear me again. Basically, I accidentally launched two H1Z1 clients, so OBS did not know what to do with that. All right, let me answer some questions. How is H1Z1 better than DayZ? Now, that's a tough question for me to answer. I don't want to say better. I want to say different, and only because I'm really trying to be very respectful of other people's games. There may be some things I think are better, but I'm not the kind of guy to just brag that ours is better than somebody else's. You know what? They're the ones with a beautiful game that's launched, and we're not. So I'm not going to go that way. But what I will say is, I think our interface is a little easier to use. I like stuff like jumping. I like it slightly more gamey, just a little bit though. And by gamey, this is exactly what I'm talking about. I can jump over this. I don't know why I'm so excited about that, but I'm a gamer. When I play WoW, I sit there and hop up and down all day. When I play PlanetSide 2, you know, I like being able to do stuff like that. So that's just one bad example. The H1Z1 virus itself being infected, that's a huge differentiator. We really want to make this a zombie apocalypse simulator with tactical military elements. So this is a tactical game. It's not designed at all to be played as a first-person shooter. That's not what this game is. It's a much slower-paced game. And it's probably going to bore a lot of the Call of Duty players because it's just too slow for them. Smedley, have you heard a lot of people talking about concrete-looking textures, even toilets? Yes, and we are in the... A lot of the textures that you see in the game are placeholder, and a lot of work needs to be done. So, but when you say stuff looks like concrete, here, let me go into town and show you. Part of what you guys are seeing is an artifact of the stream. Hold on. And what do I mean by that? Well, hold on. And by the way, will somebody tell Favali that display thing doesn't always work right? It doesn't stay. Okay, so yes, there are some textures that look like concrete. Those are typically concrete textures. But what some of the artifacts that you see in... There's a concrete texture. That's an actual concrete building. But I think you can agree that's brick. So I think what they mean by concrete looking, I think they mean muddy looking. And part of that problem is very simple. There is a filter that's going on in the world that when it's going, it kind of makes things look a little muddier on the stream. So I think we need to, this door isn't working. I think we need to turn that stuff off when we're streaming, and I think you'll get a better idea of it. But admittedly, there's a lot of placeholder textures, and the guys are working on it. So, will there be horses? Yes, there will be horses. Not at EA. So, yeah, it's the film grain filter. That's the one I was talking about. Sorry, I was not remembering what it was called. Will zombie dismemberment be a feature? Negative. There's another beautiful example of a debate on the team. It's probably a taste great, less filling argument. There are a lot of people on the team that actually would prefer if we had dismemberment. I probably am one of those, but I tend towards the sicker side of movies and games too. So, and we're worried about that turning off a large segment of our audience. So, it's a concern. How long does it take to fix bugs or get new items in the game? Totally depends on the bug. If you've ever programmed anything in your life, you'll know that. Back in my programming days, bugs can take 2 seconds to fix. You know, it could be just be a semicolon. Bugs can take, you know, a week to fix. Bugs can take a month to fix. Totally depends on the bug. And new items, it's easy to get those in the game. One thing we don't have right now is backpacks auto going in inventory the way they should. Hold on, I'll go get back and get that torch, but first I gotta lead these zombies away. Something else we're doing is zombie noisemakers, so you can distract zombies. That'll be a pretty cool feature. And that's gonna be pretty simple. You'll just be able to throw something, and if it's, depending on the type of object it is, it'll actually, you know, attract the zombies to where that is. By the way, those of you wondering why the ground is white, it's pretty simple. Slide out. Let me cheat. Uh-oh. That was a mistake. Always have to remember to go down to the ground before you turn off Superman. Torch. Well, here's one place where we're better than DayZ. We've got torches. We've got fire. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. And I'm gonna die. All right, folks. I want to thank you guys for watching. I think that's it for today. I will be doing these on occasion, kind of in between our major streams, and just to answer questions. So thank you all for watching me. I appreciate your time, and hope you guys just get a better sense of why we're not quite ready for EA yet, and I hope you'll bear with us. Thank you, guys, and have a great day.